Are you all right, sir?
Yes, I'm fine.
Is there anything I can do for you? Should I call your physician?
No. Good night, Fred.
Good night, Mr. President.
There he is, Alex Gardner, when he was 19 years old.
I worked with him for a year and a half. He was an authentic genius, this boy. Exceptionally gifted. Telekinesis was only one of his talents.
I remember reading about him. Caused quite a controversy at the time. Then in the middle of it, he disappeared.
Yeah, he ran out on us. After months of intensive parapsychological testing. Didn't like being poked and prodded. Who dies?
He's perfect. I want him.
Yes, you're right, of course. He would be perfect. If we can find him.
You leave that to me. If he's alive, I'll find him.
They're off! Right, he moved, taking the lead. Admiral Water is second, then completely fine. Followed by Cover the Bet, Heavy Rain, and High Crescent. Around the turn and scraping away down the back stretch. Great Loop in front by a neck. Completely fine second, followed by Admiral Runner third. Then it's Heavy Rain, and High Crescent begins to move up. They turn for home. Here comes High Crescent. It's High Crescent now drawing away. High Crescent at the wire. And in a stunning upset, the winner is High Crescent.
I like Benjamin Franklin. He discovered electricity, you know.
The horses are approaching the starting gate for the 10th race.
Women on number four, place where there's no place for the last
one. No tickets at all, six winners. That means tomorrow, the 66th will need $368,000. The horses are now at the starting gate. The flag is off. They're off.
Get him!
Scooter breaking in front, followed by a trio of amphibians, Wire and Extravagant right together. Rex Scooter stumbled on the first turn, but maintained the lead. Then it was like back to amphibian, racing second by a length.
What the hell are you doing here?
Then it's back to
it's not safe in a fucking toilet anymore. Come on and grab us.
Hello, Alex.
Hi.
You could really hurt a guy's feelings the way you've been trying to avoid being off.
We don't see you around the track that often. When we do, you're always calling them right on the nose.
So I'm lucky.
Not today, pal. I can see we're going to have to teach you a little lesson about sharing the wealth. If you want to stay healthy, you and me are going to be partners.
All right, look. Look, want this? It's no problem.
Shit, get this out of the bitch!
Had an exciting day at the track.
got to get your bets down for the weekend. Call me, huh?
Alex, this is Maggie. I don't want to see you.
Mr. Gardner?
Oh, no, wrong guy. Gardner lives...
No, we know you're Alex Gardner.
Who the hell are you?
We're from Thornhill College. I'm Roy Babcock. This is Gary Finch.
We have a little proposition for you.
Yeah. Chance of a lifetime, right?
Good. Depends on you.
Oh, yeah? Well, come on. I think better than a moving car, okay? Listen, guys, I've thought this over, and I'm not really interested. Why don't you just let me off at La Siena, okay?
I know this is going to sound a bit sinister, Mr. Gardner, but we have instructions to bring you back with us.
You mean I'm being kidnapped?
Well, there are some people up at Thornhill that are anxious to meet with you.
Yeah, well, what would you do if I just opened the door and jumped, huh?
I guess I'd have to stop you. Just sit back and enjoy the ride.
Hey, answer me something.
If I can.
Am I in any danger?
Not from us.
My mother put you up to this, right? I gotta finish college or else.
Sign in, please.
Wait a minute.
Now, how am I signing anything here? I don't even know what this is all about.
Well, we can let this go.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
Have a seat. Someone will be with you. I
get the feeling he knows we're here. Hello, Alex. I'm Dr. Jane DeVries. We're glad you could come.
Well, perhaps you can tell me what the hell I'm doing here.
We wanted to talk to you about the project that we're working on.
Yeah? You have a think tank full of geniuses who want to try out a new theory?
No.
Well, look, I'm sorry, but I hung up the psychic bit when I was 19.
Well, that's fine, because we're not interested in parlor tricks here.
What are you interested in?
Dreams.
Dreams? Why the watchdog? You got something to hide?
We're a little cautious. We want to keep things to ourselves for a while.
Oh.
This is is our sleep monitoring station. Hi, guys. Hello, Dr. Green. These individuals are under observation because of the frequency of their nightmares. This man is in REM state, rapid
eye movement. When dreams occur.
Right.
I mean, I know one or two things, Dr. DeVries.
I have some more things to show you.
So, what goes on in this section?
Well, one of our areas of research is sexual dysfunction. If a man is experiencing impotency, we can determine whether the cause is physical or psychological by monitoring his sleep.
Mm-hmm. How's that?
Well, if it isn't physical, he'll experience 3 or 4 erections during the course of the night.
I see. So, Jane, what'd you do here in effect is count boners.
I can see you're going to be a real challenge to work with.
Oh, wait a minute, Doctor. I haven't agreed to anything yet.
Dr. DeVries, can I speak to you right away?
All right, I'll just be a moment.
Bit late.
Novotny. You should have known.
You're 9 years too late. You left me sitting in Chicago with an overheated biofeedback machine.
I got tied up.
Well, I didn't mind too much that you walked out on me. You could have at least let me know you were alive. I was worried.
About me or your research grant?
Both.
Well, I apologize, but we both know I'm not very good at that.
It's okay. It's a long time ago. It's good to see you.
It's good to see you, too. Do you think next time you could spare me the cloak and dagger act?
Oh, you mean you would have come if I just called?
No. Nice place you got here. Who's your decorator? Darth Vader?
Come on, we need to talk, Alex. How about some dinner in the village? A couple of drinks, okay?
All right. But before you spring for the check, I just want you to know I have no intention of spending the next 6 months with electrodes wired to my ass.
Don't worry, Alex. I can always have you dropped back into your life of playing the horses and hustling the women. I wouldn't dream of standing in the way of anything that important.
You sound as if you don't approve.
You're damn right I don't. You've got tremendous gifts, Alex, and you've chosen to piss them away.
Anything else?
No. That's it. Come on, let's eat.
Anything else?
Let's play a little game.
All right, it's your party.
Let's pretend that a man, with a little help from science, could psychically project himself inside a dream.
Okay, let's pretend.
Then pretend that once inside the dream, he could become an active participant in it. He could actually be there, right in the middle. He could feel the dream. Experience it. Even shape and alter the dream itself. Hmm? What would you say to a person like that?
That it's crazy.
You see, we've done it, Alex. Not once, but 3 times. Using 2 men with abilities and telepathy. Just similar to your own.
Going into another person's dream.
I have to see that to believe it. It's not very much to see. Just two men with their heads wired up to a machine. Because the
that piece of science fiction hardware you got, that's the hookup, right?
That's right. All the machine does is help connect your brain with the dreamers. But hopefully, once you get proficient, you won't even need the machine.
Why me?
Why you? Because you have a head start on the rest of us. You can already work your way into the conscious mind when the conditions are right. Maybe with a little help, you'll also get inside the subconscious mind, into the dreamscape.
You've got two guys who've already done this?
Look, Alex, you don't have to decide right this minute. Spend the night here. Sleep on it.
Buddy's vital signs are increasing.
Serious?
They're escalating.
Seems to have a tough time, poor kid.
And Sim, how's he doing?
Beginning to show signs of extreme agitation.
What's his blood pressure?
200 over 174 and rising.
What's?
145 and rising. 147 now.
Grave waves.
Erratic. Let's pull them out.
No problem. Let's see what you've got. How's the boy?
Pulse rate extremely rapid. It's rising fast.
EEG?
Erratic.
Something's wrong. I'm ringing you up. Buddy, wake up. Buddy? Buddy? Buddy?
What's going on inside that kid? What in God's name is he so frightened of?
Rise and shine. Morning.
What time is it?
It's early. How do you sleep? Have any dreams?
You mind if I take a leak before I give my deposition?
Sorry. Force of habit.
You want to explain last night to me?
You saw one of our psychics, Edward Sims, dream-linking with a young boy who has been suffering from chronic nightmares. I don't know what demons that boy has inside, but they were certainly too much for Edward.
I think I'd have to be out of my mind to hook up with that machine of yours.
I think you'd be out of your mind not to. Okay, there are risks, but I think they're controllable.
What's the point of it?
Look, I'm going to level with you. I'm doing this because no one has ever done it before. No one has even conceived of doing it before. The simple fact is, I'm doing it because it's exciting.
I gotta admit, it sounds tempting. But I don't think I'd get back on that merry-go-round with you.
Well, I tried. I think you could really have helped this project, Alex. Too bad. And I'm awfully sorry about this IRS business, too.
What?
Oh, maybe I didn't mention it to you. But you see, while we were searching for you, our government sources took quite an interest in your gambling winnings, and I think the IRS is figuring on about a 5-year audit.
What? What?
If you could see your way clear to join this program, I might be able to do something about it.
Novotny, you dirty son of a bitch. There is no way you're going to blackmail me into this. Do you understand that? I'm never going to do this for you. Not this way. No way. You understand? Never. Green. Green. Blue. Blue. Yellow. Red.
You're not concentrating.
Well, what's the point of this? I've done it a million times.
You've got to sharpen your psychic abilities. You'll have to learn to reach a meditative state in which your mind can conform with the dreamers.
Green. Yellow. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. I find you attractive. That's just what you were wondering, right? That's what you were thinking.
Knock it off, Alex. I'm not going to have you start trying to play mind reader with me.
Well, how else do you expect me to warm up the old whammy, huh?
Why can't you take this more seriously? For once in your life, try to use your gift for something positive.
Yeah, right. The old God-given gift, huh? Everybody deserves a piece of it. Okay, Dr. Deep Freeze. Let's get on with it.
Music with this thing?
That's a matter of opinion. Who the hell are you?
Tommy Ray Glapp.
Oh, yeah. Paul told me about you. You're the Neil Armstrong of dream waking, right?
Right. It's like walking on the moon.
Yeah? Comfortable in that? Bit okay?
Hey, you bet I could score heavy in a coat like this, huh?
Yeah, I bet. Listen, I'm gonna put on some clothes. We're gonna have a couple of beers.
Why?
I don't know. I just thought maybe.
I know what you want. I knew it the second I saw you. You want my secrets.
No, I don't. I just want some advice.
I don't give advice. I'm in this with me, myself, and I. That's it.
Sorry.
Novotny gives me free rein. Know why?
Must be your sparkling personality.
'Cause I'm the only guy, Alex. I'm the only guy who can do it.
What about Edward Sims?
They had to carry him away in a basket.
Yeah, well, Namani seems to think I'll be able to do it.
I'll order your basket.
A steel worker. I'll probably wind up in some bad beer commercial.
It'll be fine.
Oh, once you get me into this thing, just make damn sure you can get my ass back out.
We'll get you out.
party should be entering Ramsden shortly. You can begin your deep breathing. Entered Redmond. How is Alex?
Emitting a good regular alpha wave pattern. He's ready.
Stand by.
Project.
Damn real.
Bill?
Yeah.
You remember anything?
Yeah, we were on a skyscraper.
Huh?
Alex and me. A girder broke away.
I was there. I was there.
I want the CAT scan and EEG on Alex first thing in the morning.
Yeah.
Okay?
Hello, Alex.
Hello.
I'm Bob Blair. I thought it was about time we met.
What do you have to do with all this?
Oh, I just run it. For the government.
Hold it. And Devontae never said this was a government project.
No, and he was absolutely right not to. We don't particularly want our involvement in this advertised.
Well, excuse me for not shaking hands. Hey, I'm through here. Would you mind unstrapping me?
I'm afraid I can't help you there. You better wait. The nurse will come along in a minute. Alex. I just wanted to extend my congratulations to you. They told me about your successful dream link. Well done.
Thanks.
This is only the beginning, you know. We all feel that the possibilities for our program are tremendously exciting. But we've got to see that you don't jeopardize the wonderful work you've already done.
I don't follow you, Bob.
Well, you have been playing it a little fast and loose since you got here. Those unauthorized visits to the Dream Chamber, for instance, that's a bit sneaky. I'm afraid that's got to stop. Your work here is completely confidential. I feel a lot more comfortable knowing that you understand that.
Well, I'd feel a lot more comfortable if you could find someone to get me out of this rig.
You wait right there. I'll get you a nurse.
Yeah.
And, thanks.
Hi!
Is that the kid I saw linking with Edward Sims?
Yes, his name is Buddy Driscoll.
What's his story?
Take a look at these. He's tormented by recurring nightmares. The little guy's terrified of going to sleep. He's on the verge of a complete breakdown. There's not a damn thing he can do about it.
Mind if I talk to him?
I wish you would. Buddy, I'd like for you to meet a good friend of mine, Alex Gardner.
Hey, buddy.
Are you Dr. Alex?
Who, me? No, I am a doctor. I'm just staying here like you. How you doing?
Not so good.
There's somebody in my dreams.
Oh, yeah? Who?
An awful, ugly monster.
Yeah, monster.
I'd punch his lights out, but he's too big.
You'd punch his lights out, huh?
Sure I would. He keeps making me miss Little League.
Yeah? Well, you know, when I was a kid, I was like your age, still a kid, but I mean, I used to have bad dreams.
You did?
Yeah. Yeah, I found that if I could talk to somebody, it made me feel a whole lot better. So that's what I'm going to tell you, is that if you ever want to talk to somebody, talk to me.
Yeah. What do we say we get you back?
I'll come with you. Here, let's turn this train around here.
I know he'll be glad to see you.
Ah! Thanks for coming.
It's been a long time, Mr. President.
Yeah. Fred, give us a moment alone, huh? Sit down. Relax. Ah, damn. It's good to see you.
We've been through a lot together, haven't we? You and I. Fought quite a few battles.
Let's talk about those nightmares.
They're getting progressively worse. It's terrifying. I haven't slept in weeks.
Your doctor?
Oh, they're useless. It's beginning to affect my job. That's the real reason you're here, isn't it?
I'm here because I'm your friend. One of the projects I've been overseeing concerns the foremost specialists in dream research. I think they may very well be able to help.
I'll be honest with you. I think there's a reason for these dreams.
What do you mean?
It's my responsibility to bring the world back from the brink. This nuclear madness has to end. I've decided to lead personally the delegation to Geneva.
John, you can't be serious.
No. I know you're against me on this. But I'm going to make a disarmament deal with the Russians.
One thing at a time. Our first priority is your peace of mind.
Peace of mind? Where the hell are this peace of mind? I just want these damn nightmares to end.
That's what we all want. If you'll allow me, I think I can help.
How often does this occur, Mrs. Weber?
About twice a week. I wake up in the middle of the night to find George gone from our bed. And every time I find him in the same place, on the front lawn, in his pajamas, calling my name.
When Melanie wakes me up, for the life of me, I can't remember what I was dreaming. All I know is I have this terrible feeling of anxiety.
The neighbors are starting to think that George is a little crazy.
Have you been under any unusual pressure?
No, not really.
What about at home? How are you two getting along?
Well, if you're referring to our sex life, George has been having a little problem lately, but I feel certain that's just a passing thing. Isn't that right, honey?
Oh, yeah, sure. Absolutely.
I'm just a little drugged out, that's why.
Is there any pressure at work?
Well, whatever Weber's dreaming is the key to all his problems.
I'd say whoever sold him that toupee is the key to all his problems.
If you could go in. Observe his dream. That would be your first practical application.
When do I go in?
How does tomorrow night sound?
All right.
EEG is stable. Alex is ready.
Weber?
He's in room sleep.
Stand by.
Ever been married?
No.
Well, it's no picnic, let me tell you. You have to keep your eye on him every minute. My house is the next one down. I don't want to give her any warning, know what I mean? Now, here's the plan of attack. You go in through the back door, and I'll go in through the front. And remember, no prisoners.
Right.
You scared, kid?
No.
Well, let's go. Hurry now. Go ahead. Oh, my God!
George!
And with my own brother?
Hi, George.
And in front of the children. I see you under there. Come on up. Phil, Dave, Herbie, some golf buddies you are. Good God. I'll knock that off. I'm Jewish.
So sorry, Mr. Weber.
You too, Fukuda.
What do you think?
Well, it's very simple. Mr. Weber has been repressing a deep-seated inferiority complex, complicated by feelings of sexual inadequacy.
In other words,
he's worried about him stripping his wife.
Well, at least now we know what we're dealing with.
Well, look, now that you've shed some light on Weber's case, maybe you can help me with one of my problems.
Well, sure. What's that?
Buddy Driscoll, the kid in the nightmares.
Yes?
I want to go in.
That's impossible. I've already lost one psychic over this, Alex.
Well, I don't understand this. This kid is being eaten alive and nobody gives a damn.
Oh, listen, that's totally outrageous. I'm sick that we haven't been able to help him.
Well, then let me go in. I mean, look, if our research here isn't designed to help a kid like Buddy out, then what the hell are we doing, huh?
I will not destroy this program by going too fast. You see?
I either go in with Buddy or I'm out of the project.
Then you're out.
I'm not kidding around here, Paul. Either I go in or I'm walking. I know I can help this kid.
You're a bastard, you know that, Alex. I'm doing this against my better judgment.
Thanks.
Don't thank me. This isn't my idea. Drink?
Sure.
I don't have to tell you. Could be in for a rough ride.
I know that. Just tell me what I can do to help.
There is a tribe in Malaysia called the Senoi, the dream people. They believe their dream lives are just as real as their waking lives. The children are taught to never lose control in a nightmare. They've got to face their fears and conquer them. And I think that's what you have to do to help Buddy. Whatever his demon is, you have to help him face it.
Okay, Buddy, you're all set.
Can I talk to him?
Sure.
Hi.
Hi.
Feel sleepy yet? But what?
But I'll have the dream, Alex.
Yeah. You want to know a secret? I'm going to be there.
You are?
Yeah, I really am.
Okay, if you're going to be there.
Got something else for you, too.
Thanks, Alex.
Yeah.
Stand by and project.
Buddy, what are you doing?
Are you the babysitter, Alex?
Yeah, I'm the babysitter.
Because most of the time, they just leave me here.
You don't have to be afraid.
You know the snake man?
The who?
The snake man.
Snake man? What do you mean, like the boogeyman?
He's outside and he wants to come in and get me. The snake man!
Hold it. Hey. I'm not going to let him get you. Just let me see who it is, all right?
Please don't answer it.
It's probably not even him. You see, there's nobody there.
Are you sure, Alex? He's always there. That's my dad, but he won't help us.
little bastard's right.
California retreat to recuperate while he prepares for the Geneva Nuclear Disarmament Conference. White House Press Secretary James Nichols announced today the president will personally lead the United States delegation at the conference, which is scheduled to convene early next month. In an 11th-hour compromise late last night, the legislature passed a fiscal blueprint that calls for more than 600...
What are you, a cartoonist?
No, I met this thing in a kid's nightmare. It scared the hell out of me.
Yeah, I heard about that. You got these jerks thinking you can walk on water. Probably think that makes you a pretty important man around here. Almost as important as me.
Well, don't worry, Tommy. You're still number one lab rat.
This thing really got to you, huh?
You might say that. Hello, Jane.
Hello, Alex.
I'm going to the village for a bite to eat. Interested?
No, thanks.
Found a wonderful Italian place to make great linguine.
Sorry, I've got a pile of paperwork to get through.
Maybe I'm going about this all wrong. I like you, Jane.
I like you too, Alex.
You do?
But there are two reasons why I'm not going to go to bed with you.
Bed? Oh, bed. Who said anything about bed? I'm talking about linguine here.
I just thought I'd save you some time.
Okay. Since you're being so honest, why not?
First of all, I don't want to join the ranks of your conquest.
You're not a conquest. That's not the way I feel about you, Jane.
Secondly, I don't want to jeopardize our working relationship. This program has got to come first.
Okay. Friends?
Friends. You treacherous.
I'll bring you back a ravioli to go.
You work with Paul Novandi?
Paul who?
Right. Paul who? Charlie Prince.
Well, hello there.
Yeah, can we catch another beer for the Monsignor?
No, thanks. You know something? You look familiar to me.
I got one of these damn things in here somewhere.
You write these horror books?
Yeah, another one.
Great.
Boy, am I ever.
What are you doing here?
Research.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm working on a new book. It's got to do with dreams.
Yeah? Sounds like another winner.
Look, I know what's going on at Bates Hall. I know all about this Dreamlink business. I know you're a part of it.
Hey, you know about as much as I do, don't you?
Maybe I know more.
Look, you got a point to make here because I sure wish you'd make it.
I assume you've run into a tough, smooth corporate type named Bob Blair. You want to guess what he does?
He's with the government, right?
He's more than just with the government. He's one of the most powerful men in it. Head of covert intelligence. The president's coming. Oh, Bob Blair remains.
Yeah, well, if he's so powerful, then what the hell is he doing wasting his time on dream research, huh?
Consider all the deep, dark secrets that people hide away in their minds. Now, those secrets are bound to come out in their dreams, huh? It occurs to me that a technique for plumbing those secrets could be of enormous interest to certain intelligence groups. Yeah, great idea for a book, huh?
Yeah.
Still, you know what they say is stranger than fiction.
Thank you.
Jane!
Jane! Wait,
don't touch me! You had no right to do that.
Look, I'm sorry. I really am sorry. Maybe I was a little
unwanted. Maybe.
Look, all right, it just happened. What can I say? Was this so awful?
Well, it depends on the way you look at it. I mean, it was just a dream, so it didn't really happen, did it?
No, it didn't.
So if it didn't really happen, then I shouldn't be upset, should I? But I am upset, damn it.
I can see that. I'm sorry.
You know, it would help a lot if you wouldn't be so goddamn apologetic and go back to your usual insensitive self. Alex, what you did was wrong. But it doesn't take a genius to realize that what happened in the dream was something that we both wanted.
What are we going to do about that?
I don't know. We forget it.
I can't forget it.
Sorry, Alex.
Hey, Jane, you know, there's one thing you overlooked. I entered that dream without any help or hookup. I did it all on my own.
Work miracles. Is there a possibility the president can be helped?
A possibility? No guarantee.
Why are you getting involved in this?
Because we're the only ones who can help him now. Man is falling to pieces, Paul. He's just sitting there in the Oval Office making decisions based on his nightmares.
He certainly wouldn't be the first world leader to take his dreams seriously.
No, but he could be the first to destroy his country because of it.
Isn't that overstating things a tiny bit?
Do you realize what he plans to do in Geneva? He's going to emasculate our nuclear deterrent and bring the whole damn country to its knees. Because of his dreams.
Well, I'm not going to allow that to happen. Paul, you and I are going to bring the president here, and we're going to use everything that we have in our power to save him.
What is the readout of Mrs. Matusik?
Blood pressure 126 over 84. EKG normal.
Hi.
Hi.
Still mad at me?
No, but I've been thinking.
Dr. DeVries, I was under the impression we were conducting scientific research here.
Excuse me.
Pulse rate 95, 97. Her pulse is starting to rise, rising fast. Her EKG shows rapid contractions. V-fib, she's fibrillating.
Oh my God, Paul, she's having a massive coronary.
Code blue! Code blue! Get a crash cart in here right away.
On. Get the D-tip ready. 400 watt seconds. Do you want bicarb? Yes, and calcium chloride.
I think that is fair.
Straight line.
Clear. Stand clear.
Once more.
Stand clear.
Is there a pulse?
Nothing's happening. Let's try once more.
Alex, would you mind? I really gotta be alone. I'm still shook up about Mrs. Matusik. She must have had a bum ticker. Fucking shame. You may not know to look at me, but I'm a pretty sensitive guy. It really affected me.
Didn't affect your appetite.
I eat to forget. Let go. Let go or you're gonna draw back a stump.
A woman died, Tommy.
Everybody dies.
Can I have a word with you for a moment, please?
Certainly.
This isn't the way I want it at all. The president will be staying in the North Wing.
But the North Wing is impractical. I've got everything I need right here.
Well, you just have to make other arrangements.
I'm sorry, but this is my area of expertise, not yours.
I have considerations that you know nothing about, Paul. Just see that it's done.
What considerations?
Security, for one.
Oh, come on. That's ridiculous. If you're concerned about security, then this wing is clearly the easiest one to isolate.
You can't handle the move. My people will do it for you.
What are you up to, Blair?
Paul, I don't want to get into a debate over this. My sole concern is the well-being of the president.
I don't know what you're concerned with anymore, Blair. But is it really the well-being of the president?
How's my good right arm?
Climbing the fucking walls. This place is starting to close in on me.
I haven't been taking anything.
I don't touch drugs.
Good.
I'm messed up enough. He says what people tell me.
Well, they're wrong, Tommy. You lacked direction, that's all.
Yeah. It took a guy like you to understand me, Bobby boy.
All I did was channel your talents, son.
When are you gonna cut me loose from this dump? You promised you had big plans for me.
I do. That's why I'm here.
About all this clandestine crap, but I like to keep a close watch on things.
Yeah, I noticed.
I had to let you know you're in danger.
What's going on here, Charlie? Last week I would have laughed at you. I'm not so sure about what's going on.
The stakes are a little higher than I imagined. Mr. Blair is playing for keeps. That woman who linked with Tommy Ray didn't just die of a heart attack.
What are you saying?
I'm saying Blair's a ruthless killer. Officially, his organization doesn't even exist. I mean, these are the guys even the CIA are afraid of.
What, you mean he's training me to be some kind of a spy?
No, no, no. He wants more than spies, Alex. He wants assassins.
Charlie.
Come on.
that she killed him.
Prince was dangerous, an amateur. He would have blown the cover off the whole project.
You murdered him.
Yes, I did.
You had Tommy Ray kill that woman in the dream link, didn't you?
Yes.
Why?
I wanted to see if it could be done.
You're a real humanitarian, Blair.
I'm a realist. We live in a dangerous, hostile world. I will do whatever I have to keep this country safe.
That's what scares me.
You're a very intelligent young man, Alex. You've mastered an amazing technique. Surely you can see the possibility. During his dream link with Matuzik, Tommy Ray stabbed her with a knife, a dream knife. Shock to Matuzik's system caused a coronary, and she died. So the old wives' tale comes true after all. When you dream that you die in life. The very same instant. Now we can go into an enemy's dream, kill him, make it look as if he died in his sleep. Do you realize what that means?
It means no one's safe from you.
The question is whether you're going to cooperate. I never had any doubts about Tommy Ray.
Well, why should you? He killed his own father. He's a fucking psychopath.
Alex, it's very simple. Either you work for me or you die.
Good to be here, Bob.
Hello.
Jane.
Alex?
Look, listen to me. Blair is out of control. I saw his people last night. They killed a man right in front of me.
Blair's here now. He's brought the president with him.
President?
Of the United States?
Yes.
About what?
He thinks the president's in danger.
No, you can't call the cops. Blair owns the cops and the FBI.
Alex?
Jane, I'm coming back. We've got to stop Blair.
Listen, there's security everywhere. I'll leave the door open at the loading dock. I think it's your best chance.
You be careful.
You just keep yourself alive.
Count on it.
Snead, let me talk to Snead. Come on.
Hey, Snead!
Snead!
This better be good.
because McLaren there, he just loved to tear you a new asshole.
Snead, I need your help.
Now, why should I help?
Come on, Snead, do me a favor. I'll give you three winners.
Make it six.
Five.
You're on.
Burnett, look, there's going to be some people coming here in a couple of minutes. They're going to be in a hurry, and I want you to slow them down for me.
No problem. Hey, Alex, you Welsh me. You're a dead man.
Does not concern you.
Oh, I think it does. I'm afraid everything concerns me now.
Will you excuse me?
If something's deeply troubling you, let's sit down and talk about it.
Should we really? Should we talk about what you intend to do to the president?
I thought that was clear. I intend to put an end to his nightmares.
Well, that I'm sure of. It's over now, Blair. I'll see to that.
No one's going to believe you.
By God, I'll make them believe me. I came to you with important research designed to illuminate. Not to destroy.
Didn't I provide you with everything you needed?
You took something that was vital and very important, and you corrupted it.
You let me.
Yes. To my eternal shame.
Thank you.
Alex, thank God you're here.
He's gonna die in his sleep, Tommy. After all the stress he's been undergoing lately, no one will suspect a thing. So don't worry.
Regular heroes, aren't we, Bob?
Take it from here.
Fine. I'm gonna stay with Blair. Make sure the car is clean when you're done.
Right.
All right, no loud noises. I'm gonna make a loud one. You hear me?
Don't be a fool.
Why did Blair bring the president here?
Some tests.
Alex.
What? What is it?
Come here.
All right, out of the car. Come on.
Oh, God. Paul.
I didn't do it. Blair's planning on putting Tommy away in the president's dream, right?
Tell me. Yes.
How's he gonna do it? The dream chamber?
Alex, come on.
Tell me, you son of a bitch, or I'm gonna put your brains all over this car.
Hey. The president's in the room next to Tommy Ray. When the president goes to sleep,
that's all I want.
No!
Let's go. Going into that dream, I'm gonna stop Tommy Ray.
He's asleep. Won't be long before I can go in.
Let's use my office. It's right beneath the president's room. I think you'll be close enough there to link.
No lights. Lock the door.
Take your time, Alex. Otherwise, you won't be able
to... Screw otherwise. Might be too late already.
It's not working.
Okay. Now use your breathing.
President, listen to me. Your life is in danger. Bob Blair is trying to kill you.
What the hell are you talking about?
He sent somebody into this dream to assassinate you.
Who are you?
I'm here to help you. Look, all you gotta do is wake up.
Wake up?
That's right. Wake up. Try. Concentrate. Wake up.
They gave me a sedative.
Sedative? Well, we're just gonna have to ride this out till it wears off.
I did this. I caused it.
That's not true. It's all a dream. None of it's real.
Hello, Mr. President. Alex, what a surprise. I get to kill two for the price of one.
Okay, what seems to be the trouble here?
No trouble. No trouble at all.
Then move on, son.
Abracadabra.
You sick bastard!
Alex, have a heart.
It's a dream, Alex. There's anything you wanted here. Haven't you figured that out yet? Push the button. He did this to you. He did this to you. He did this to you. I saw Enter the Dragon 6 times. You blew it, Alex. While you were fooling around with Novotny, I was learning how to take advantage in here. In this world, you're nothing, Alex. And me, I'm God. End of the line, boys. I know something you're really afraid of, Alex.
Maybe we don't run.
Tommy Ray. Why, Tommy? Why'd you do it to me? Why, Tommy?
Daddy?
I loved you, Tommy Ray.
Daddy, I'm sorry.
He's dead. Dead.
Alex, are you all right? What happened?
It's okay. I stopped the bastard.
Is anything the matter?
You all right?
Bob, stay away from me.
Excuse us, gentlemen.
No. No excuses. Don't leave me for an instant.
Let's go back to your room.
I'm not going anywhere with you. You put that maniac in my dream to kill me.
I wonder if you know just how crazy that sounds, Mr. President.
You'll never get away with this.
You can't touch me, John. And you know that.
We're leaving.
I think we should get as far away from here as possible.
You're damn right. Hold it right there.
Okay. Thank you. I don't know how you did it, but thank you for my life.
I'm just glad we got out of there in one piece, Mr. President. Sir, what about Bob Blair?
Blair? He's a very powerful man.
He's gonna be coming after me. He can't afford to have me alive.
I'll assign some men to you.
I appreciate that, sir. But I think I should deal with this on my own.
How did you get in here?
It was easy.
Adventure? You call going to Louisville an adventure?
What's wrong with Louisville?
Churchill Downs is in Louisville. You don't happen to be planning on doing any gambling.
Jane, you know I never gamble.
So then why are we going?
Where we're going is not important. What's important is that it takes 3 days to get there.
I haven't been on a train in years.
No, that's not exactly true, Jane.
It'd be nice.
Wait a minute. What if it's not as good as the dream?
It will be.
How do you know?
Maybe I'm a little bit psychic.
Yeah. Tickets? Tickets, please.
Thank you. Have a good trip.